All right, he is the breakout star of Ryan Murphy's ninth installment of the American Horror Story franchise. We're turning it back to 1984 with a true L.A. scary story. We're going to talk with actor Zach Vila about that, but we're now dragging him into our debate about rice pilaf versus other kinds of rice.
These are the things we talk about in the commercial break, Zach.
Yeah. Great.
Yeah. Well, you know.
We've defined pilaf, Zach.
Versus rice.
Defined it? Like, you know what food group it belongs to.
Yes, exactly.
And we're coming out with a line of bumper stickers. Honk if you like pilaf.
Fantastic.
Doesn't rice pilaf contain other elements besides grains of rice?
Yes. Soup stock. Typically.
Yes.
Some sort of stock, concentrates.
Or concentrates.
Sorry, Zach.
Zach, talk to me about the top of your head.
Oh, what's going on?
Yeah.
You know, it just keeps me awake in the morning. When I look in the mirror, the bright colors are just really...
Very festive there.
Yeah.
All right. Here's
It's fall. It's fall.
Right, it's fall. What of course. Zach, as nice as can be in real life, he portrays the L.A. Night Stalker, serial killer and rapist Richard Ramirez. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you are from here, that's an unbelievably heavy name and an unbelievably heavy backstory.
Sure.
When you're assigned that role, talk to me about that.
You know, it's challenging because, of course, there's historical precedent for all the terrible things that he did. And, you know, L.A.ers know that story. And a lot, when I got the role, there were so many people that came up to me and they're like, oh, we were there when Richard was captured on the street, or he tried to break into my house. And, you know, it's, I mean, it's just really terrible, like the reign of terror that he had. So for me coming into the role, I had to pay homage and get some of the things from history, you know, that were so terrible, but also the show is kind of revamping it in its own way. And so blending those two worlds were difficult.
Yeah. All right. Well, this was deliberate. They have not shown me the clip. They said, you're going to be freaked out when you see it. So we'll all see it together. This is from American Horror Story. Oh, gosh.
Wow.
Please.
Yeah.
The laugh alone.
I don't know what happened there. It's me coming back from the dead.
You know, and why not?
Possibly with some satanic help.
Well.
Yeah.
And so when they say cut.
Yeah.
What do you, can you, like, oh, I'd like a latte, please.
It wasn't quite that casual.
Right.
But, yeah, after they floated me down on the wires, I mean, you know, look, we're working really long hours, and it's very cold out in the woods. And but yeah, I mean, you know, you try to turn it off in between takes and joke around. It's some very heavy material, obviously.
No question about that. And then, when the totality of the role is over,
yes,
does it take a while to kind of leave it all behind?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, we're still shooting, so.
Oh wow. Okay.
I mean, I have to go to work later today and step into Richard's voice, body, and try to sustain that. But yeah, I mean, look, in my real life, I luckily look so different on screen that I don't get recognized or harassed that often. But like when I go into other auditions and other work, it's difficult because I've spent so much time in his mind and his body. And so the voice comes out a lot, which is frustrating.
Right, and be it the crew or the fellow cast members, because it's such an effective portrayal, are they standoffish?
No, I think in the beginning I had to keep my distance just to set myself apart and stay in that headspace. But as the season's gone on, it's easier to flip a switch off and on, you know? I mean, it's all a big family, and we're all working very hard and supporting each other.
Well, there you are. American Horror Story 1984 airs Wednesdays at 10 on FX. Nice to see you this morning.
Thank you.
So much.
Thanks for having me, guys.
Thank
you. Good morning.